Hello, and welcome to the National Science Teachers Association Learning Center. I'm your host, Amanda, and today I'm going to show you how to build your library of resources. One of the amazing things about the NSTA Learning Center is the opportunity for collaboration with almost 200,000 science teaching professionals across the United States. We have thousands of resources available, and this is a dynamic space for finding and sharing those resources and collaborating with other science teaching professionals to bring accurate, relevant, and engaging lessons to your learners. Let's get started by building our library. Click My Library. This will bring you to the My Library page. If you scroll down the page, you can see that your library is organized in two ways. First is through collections. This is where you bundle your resources, which makes it really easy to share. You can view your collections, if you have any, by pressing the plus sign. And then you have a running tab of your resources. You can see I have one resource here. I've already started my search for technology in the science classroom, and we'll continue that through the Explore All Resources page. So go ahead and navigate to the Explore All Resources page. You can see up here at the top, you can search by keyword, or if you scroll down the page, you can browse by what's new, what's popular. You can filter by grade level, or you can search through a variety of our media types. We have audiovisual, books, events, forums, do-it-yourself learning, journal articles, online courses, online events, web seminars, browsing articles by journal, and virtual conferences. Whew. We also have some incredible content collaborators. Here we have National Aeronautics and Space Administration. Yeah, that's right, that's NASA. Now that we are oriented with the types of resources, let's scroll up to the top and try an example. Let's say I'm researching for a grant for technology in the science classroom. I'll type in the keyword technology, hit search. It's going to take a minute because there are, wowzer, over 700 resources, 763 to be exact. All right, let's see what we have got here. If I scroll down the page, I can see that this is a pretty broad search with just one key term. So I've got technology and human impact on the environment. That's not quite right, but this looks promising right here. I've got technology education in classrooms. I can see the price there. But for our purposes, I'm going to filter by free. So I'll go ahead and click free, which refreshes the page for me. And I still have 273 free resources to choose from. So let's see what we have. Top of the page, I have a journal article connecting with technology. This looks promising. So I'm going to click the title. That'll give me a more detailed preview of the resource. And I'm going to see, hey, there's some approaches here to technology. I've got two defined approaches. I'm going to go ahead and add that to my library by clicking the Add to My Library button. That'll immediately show me the resource. It was a free resource, so it added it. And I can see, okay, I've got that resource. I'm going to double check and see if that's in my library. I want to keep my search open, so I'm going to open my library in a different tab, and we'll see if that actually worked. So scrolling down, hey, where there was one, there's now two resources. I am growing my library. It is that simple. I'm going to go back to my search, and you can see I've got this resource now, and I can use these buttons right here to either move to the next resource or search my last set of results. So I'll scroll down, and that is one resource. And the second resource provided looks really promising as well. Education Technology in the Classroom, a whole book chapter? Yeah, I'm going to check that out. Take a look at this. I'll preview this description here, see if it's about right for me. And if it looks good, I'll go ahead and do the same thing. I'll go up to that big blue button and click Add to My Library. And it'll automatically refresh the page and open up to the book chapter. So I can read it right there. And I can see that it's in my library because it says Open in My Library. If I don't believe it, I can go back to my library, refresh the page, and see that it's there. Believe me, it's there. So I'm going to go back to All Search Results. And I'm going to refine my search a little bit by adding another keyword. So I'm going to add tools. I'll add another key term. And you play around with this just like you do a Google search. And I can see that, hey, this gives me another journal article. I like this. Career simulations. I've got some practical applications. This looks like good verbiage. It looks like this resource I already own. So I'm going to open it in my library. Imagine yourself winning this grant because you did such great research. Woohoo! I'm going to go back. I know that it's in my library. I'm feeling pretty good about my resources so far. And I'll go and I'll see how my library has been growing. Go ahead and click that library navigation button. That'll bring me back to my library. And I can scroll down and look at the resources. But you know what? I'm going to share this with a colleague and I'm going to upload my own resource. So I click upload my own. And I'll go to sample lessons and I'm going to add an example lesson just so I can get my colleagues jazzed about what I might do if given technological resources. And I'll go ahead and title it. Oh, I don't even need to title it because I want it to stay the same name as my file. And I'll just upload my file. It'll tell me that my upload was successful and I can return to my library. All right, so now I have four resources for my grant. The next thing that I might do is share those resources, and we'll do that through collections, which I'll share with you guys in another video. Thank you for joining me in the Learning Center. I hope to see you in the forums.